Hey, what's up guys? My name is Ess and welcome back to another episode of Dirty Bomb. So today we're gonna talk about the new crafting system. They talked about this a lot in yesterday's dev stream. So let's talk about it. First things first, I actually want to kind of give a shout out to Live On Music. In the background you can hear his music. This is called Chilled Out, his latest song. I will leave a link in the description. You can check out his channel. He's a really cool dude. He also plays Dirty Bomb and he's starting to make his own music. He has a couple songs. I think it's pretty good and he has some potential. And I would really like it if you check him out. So the new crafting system. For the people who don't know, I talked about this, I think last week's video, the recycle system, the dusting system it's also called. Now it is the crafting system, because this is gonna replace trade-ins and trade-ups. So of course that's a huge thing just alone, but there is actually a shit ton of stuff, and I have written down like a buttload of stuff because there is a lot of stuff to talk about, and I've said stuff like 10 times. So the main thing about this like crafting system is that the devs, and especially Exodore, wants a system just to be like a lot smoother, a lot less clicks, because right now if you want to go to a gold from Let's, it takes a million clicks, really repetitive, and it isn't really clear how to do it for new players, and it's just a really stupid system in general. So that's the main thing, just really quick and easy. And they also mentioned that the general cost of the cards and also the money will roughly be the same, and actually they said they are kind of generous and rounded down, so the overall cost will be slightly less for most cards. So now you have the option to, with one click, delete all of your LEDs, all of any rarity actually. You can also select delete all or scrap all your duplicate cards. So the thing that you get is fragments. That's kind of the parts that you will get in the dusting video. They call them, I believe, components. Now they are actually going to be called fragments, which is quite nice. They haven't got actual picture currently, but they are probably gonna be shards or something. Exodore said that in the stream. Now by default you have a 1 in 9 chance, so it's the same as actually trading up of getting a card, but there's actually a lot more and the system is a lot more in-depth than it is currently. So as Exodore said, premium cards, and at first I thought he meant like special cards, but he meant silvers, golds and cobalts. Those you can actually use and buy kits for them to kind of have better odds of getting your specific card, and also lower the credit cost. So basically what you do, you can scrap old cards just by dragging them into the bin, and then you have to confirm them so you can delete anything accidentally, and also like favorited cards or your favorite cards won't actually be able to scrap, so you have to unfavorite those. But basically you drag them to the thingy, and then just by hovering over it, it will say how much it's worth. But currently, let's actually see, because I wrote this down, LEDs are 15, irons of 80, bronze is 400, silver 800, gold 3000, and then cobalts are 12,000 components or fragments. So those are the values. They will release the official values within the couple next days. They've said that during the stream. But the first thing that I really jumped out, for me at least, is the kind of ratios. It really, really seems really stupid, actually. So from lead to iron, it is 5.3 times more. Iron to bronze, it's 5 times more. But from bronze to silver, it's only double the amount of components you get. Silver to gold is 3.75, so that's actually quite fair. And then gold to cobalt is 4 times as much. And this is really strange, because currently, of course, from lead to iron is 3 times. Iron to bronze is also 3 times. Bronze to silver is, I believe, 4 times. And then silver to gold also 4. And gold to cobalt is 6, but now you only get 4 times as much. So I think just the ratios of that is really, really strange. And this will really help you decide if you should now trade up all of your cards to a certain rarity or weight and then scrap them. My personal best guess is just to get all of your irons and leads to bronze, because that's just the best value, and then scrap the bronzes and go for the golds and silvers or even cobalts, whatever you want. So like I was saying, you can actually now craft your favorite cards by using these components or fragments. So the cost of an iron card will be 45, a bronze 300, a silver 1600, a gold 70, 6700, and then a cobalt 20, 2,800 fragments. Now, alongside with the fragment cost, you also have, of course, still the credit cost. And Exodore, like I said, has said that it, generally it will be a little bit cheaper, and they were generous, they said. So for iron and bronze, we don't actually have the values, but my best guess would be 500 and 2,000 respectively. For silver, gold and cobalt, we do actually have values, and that is 5,000, 15,000 and 40,000 credits. So meaning if you want to craft the cobalt, you will need to pay first off the 22,800 fragments and then 40,000 credits on top of that. So that's absolutely insane, but we will come back on that. Now, of course, they also introduced a new kind of system where they can make more money from it, which I guess is a good thing for a free-to-play game. But the way they are doing it right now, or at least like they show how they will do it, I'm not 100% sure if it is actually going to be like how they shown it, but it is really confusing in my opinion. So you can now buy kits. You have weapon kits and you have crafting kits. The weapon kits allow you to pick any specific primary weapon for your card. So if you, let's say, want a thunder, but you want, you have to have the Tamik, you need to pay a weapon kit. So how you get those is, of course, by paying. You can't actually do get those by spending credits, and there is also a chance you will get them from arsenal crates, but they will be extremely rare, probably more rare than the current 18 and 12 hour boosters. So for silver you need one kit, but for a gold you need 5 weapon kits. For cobalt they didn't show that, but my best guess would be 8 or something, or I guess actually 10, because they show that in the packs. So this isn't really a bad thing, but the bad thing is that they also show the prices. Now, they didn't talk about it. I think that was a good thing, because they would absolutely get roasted on the stream. But what we could see is that currently, at least, and now, like I said, I don't know if this is really the pricing, but weapon kits, just one, is £5.80, which is roughly, I do believe, €7. Now, remember, you need one kit for just the silver, and you will probably need 10 for cobalt, and will definitely 5 for gold, because they show that. That is just $35 if you want a specific weapon for a gold card. So I don't really know if this is actually going to be it, because just I can't imagine this is actually that price, because that would be ridiculous, even for splash damage Nexon. I mean, you can buy just a 10 pack of elite cases, probably get a lot more stuff, a lot better stuff. So another thing they have actually shown are the crafting kits, and this is basically for the people who have too little time, or maybe are value their credits a lot. Basically, you don't have to pay any credit fee, and instead you pay this credit fee by paying it with crafting kits. So currently the crafting kits, just one, is £0.80, so roughly $1, and then the 5 pack is £3.60, and the 8 pack is £5.30 again. So for silver you need to pay one kit, for a gold one you need to pay 3 kits, and for a cobalt one you need to pay 8 kits. So roughly, if you want to buy or make a cobalt card, you want to do this by basically paying the fee with real life money, you roughly pay €8. So I guess the thing is really, like, the idea is pretty good, but the pricing is ridiculous. Now again, I don't know if it is actually done and these will be the final values. I can't really imagine they will, because it's just absolutely ridiculous. Now then, back to another point, the values for the trade-up costs just in general. Now, Exodore said that the trade-up cost for a cobalt one is so expensive because you basically don't need to pay all of the steps from lead to cobalt, and I totally agree. If you would do that, you know, it would be something like 300,000 credits. But what he didn't thought or didn't say is that a lot of people, of course, have already high valuable cards or high rarity of cards, so gold, silvers and bronze. So let me take a guess. Which people do have a lot of valuable cards? Veterans, yes. Oh, we can screw those over. They get used to it. They come back. They have kind of a soft spot for this game. And we also have like a lot of silvers and golds. Paying customers, of course, the paying customers. Well, we can fuck those. We have done that before. So yeah, see my point? It is absolutely ridiculous that the trade-up cost is so high. Now, I can totally understand if you drop in, I believe you needed to drop in 1600 leads, and then you can straight away craft a cobalt for just 40,000 credits, which is actually a really good deal. So let's say you buy a elite pack, a 10 pack. You have really good luck and you get actually 2 golds and the rest are silvers, and you decide to scrap all of those because you already have them or you don't really care for the loadouts. So you have enough fragments, but now you need to pay 40,000 1000 credits to get a cobalt. So first off, you pay 35 euros, and then you also need to pay 40,000 credits, which is just insane. Like Cliff said, he also made a video, like, before you needed, I believe, 10,000. That's pretty feasible, like, you can get that in a day or maybe 2 days playing, but 40,000 is a real grind, especially for people who don't have all of the mercs yet. Like, that's a tough decision. Do I want a cobalt card or do I want a freaking merc? So again, I think this is a really cool system, and I was so excited about it, but because of things like this, and also, like I said in the beginning, the ratios between the cards, I think they really screwed it up. They didn't really do all the math, I think. Like, he literally said they rounded down and up just to make it look nice, like round numbers, but just the ratios between gold and cobalt, they are not right. Gold currently is 6 times more rare than a cobalt one, and now it's only 4, so you kind of make either cobalt less rare or gold more rare, depending how you look at it. I don't know. Really cool system. I don't know if it's actually going to be well implemented. So actually, two counter arguments I kind of forgot to say is that buying elite cases versus, for instance, expert cases now can be a little bit more fair, because actually the difference between bronze and silver is only like 100%, so 400 fragments versus 800. So maybe they did it because of that, because then you actually get the same amount of fragments per dollar. And also, there is a chance, of course, you can trade your cards via the Steam market, so maybe this whole thing won't really be a problem, but I don't really know currently. And that really worries me. I have a lot of faith in them, but if they keep pulling stuff like this, I don't know. I really don't know. Like I said, these might not be the final values. They will release them the coming couple of days, and I really hope they will make the best of it, because I really want to see this system succeed. But right now, I don't really know. I really don't know. Now, there are a couple more things, actually. So first of all, Exodor was really happy with this new system, because he was really happy because it basically is a new currency, of course. So he was talking about maybe doing it for events, just like we saw with Rogue and Vogue with the cycles. I was thinking maybe they could do it with like mission bonuses or first day rewards. I think that would be really cool. You could even have a daily login bonus. I don't know how cheesy that would be, but I think that would be pretty cool. Now, also he said he doesn't want them to become like really easy to get, and I agree, because I think basically it's part of cards you are giving away, and cards should be really rare, either being purchased or just by obtaining them by playing at the absolute shit out of this game. And also, what a lot of people don't get is that these cards need to be value, and valuable cards is a really good thing for everybody. So for the developers, because of course if the cards aren't valuable, no one will pay for them, especially not the prices they are asking currently. Also the free-to-play players, because once trading becomes a thing, if they actually do get a silver, a gold, or a cobalt or whatever, and they don't care for that, they can sell it and make a profit. Really nice. I did that when I was younger and I didn't have like a credit card or bank account and stuff. And also for the veterans and for the really diehard players, because they actually want those cards to be valuable, because they are rare, and then people will look at them and be kind of jealous. And also they will be willing to spend real life money or just an absolutely shit ton of playtime in order to get them. So yeah, like I said, I think if you buy premium cases, they kind of screw you, because no matter what you get, you will probably trade it up, because a lot of people that buy elite cases or expert cases have already a lot of cards, and are just most of the cards they will get will be used as trade-up material. So for those people, they really get fucked, I think, in my opinion. Now, one solution I have for this, and I think that would be actually a quite a nice solution in my opinion, is to, if you buy a certain amount of cards or cases, I should say, you would get a few crafting kits, maybe even a weapon kit if you buy like a elite 10 pack or even a 5 pack, to kind of throw those in as freebies, quote unquote freebies, because then if you have a really bad unboxing, let's say 10 silvers for a elite case 10 pack, then you still have those kits which you can use to at least make the trade-ups a little bit cheaper, or the craftings, I should say. So I think that would be a really great idea, because a lot of people of course complain now that the case packs are way too expensive, and I can totally agree. I've bought way too many, and I can tell you the disappointment is real. The disappointment is real. Like, I've had only a couple of good unboxings from like maybe 15 unboxings I've done. So basically, by doing this, you make the packs more valuable and people will buy them. And actually, the best thing of it is that you don't have to devalue the cards by throwing in either extra cases, making the cases cheaper, which I think will be a bad thing, just because first off, you will fuck a ton of people who already put in hundreds of dollars by buying the cases, and also you will devalue the cards like like drastically. So this way you don't have to put in extra cases or maybe guaranteed cards, but just the extra freebie kits. So yeah, I hope I informed you a lot of my opinions in this one. I hope I explained everything. Like I said, I've so much stuff written down and I've been thinking about this all day because actually, like I said, I really want to see this system to be good and I really hope it is good, but currently, like the values we have and just the pricing especially, and I know you can just say, well, don't bother with it by the like real world kits, but just the crafting with the actual credits is also really expensive. And I know for the vast majority, let's say 80 or maybe even 90%, it will be cheaper because they solely rely on the like equipment cases to do the trade up. So this will be a lot cheaper because you can just throw the things in. You don't need to save up money for the trade ups. You can just save up, buy a ton of cases and then get your desired card. And again, it is of course a lot faster, so it will be very interesting, but I don't know. I was like really excited and now I'm kind of meh. It's kind of meh-ish. So when is this update actually coming out? They've said next week or either week after that. So the next coming 2 weeks will be very interesting what we'll see. They were talking about a content update, so maybe they have even more stuff than just the new crafting system. We'll have to wait and see. It is actually really soon because in the video, the recycle video from last week, I said it would probably take like a couple months. So they really, really surprised me on this one. So anyways, I hope you liked this video. Please leave a like if you did. Subscribe if you haven't already and I will see you in the next one.